गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रियंका बंसल फ्रॉम एसकेएम पब्लिक स्कूल. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव स्टार्टेड अ चैप्टर गुडविल. इन द अर्लियर वीडियोस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ गुडविल एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फर्स्ट मेथड ऑफ गुडविल ऑल्सो. एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट गुडविल इज वैल्यूड बाय द थ्री मेथड्स. ओके, फर्स्ट इज एवरेज मेथड, second is super profit method. This is average profit method, super profit method, and third is capitalization method. Okay, goodwill can be valued by the three methods. We are doing which chapter? We are doing valuation of goodwill, and the goodwill can be valued by the three method. And keep one thing in mind that only purchased goodwill will be valued. Okay, only purchased goodwill will be valued, and it can be valued by the three methods: average profit method, super profit method, and the capitalization method. And in the last video, I have posted the concept of average profit method. Okay, I have posted the steps which are used to calculate the goodwill, which are used to calculate the goodwill by the average profit method. And today we will discuss this method by solving a numerical problem. Okay, हम क्या है एक numerical question करेंगे, so that we can understand that how the goodwill will be valued through the average profit method. Okay, so let's start with the numerical. There is a question that Simran purchased Anita's business on 1st April 2019. It was agreed to value goodwill at 3 years purchased of average net profit. See one thing, that the first condition of goodwill valuation, that it is purchased goodwill. Okay, in the question itself, it is given that the goodwill is purchased, and I have told you that the valuation of goodwill will be done for that goodwill only which is purchased. Okay, so see this question. Simran purchased Anita's business on 1st April 2019. It was agreed to value at 3 years of purchase. Here I am making the working notes. Okay. First is given that the goodwill is purchased. So the first condition is fulfilled that the goodwill should be purchased for the valuation. Okay, it is not self-generated goodwill. It is related to purchased goodwill. That's why we will do the valuation of goodwill. Second is, it was agreed to value goodwill at 3 years purchased of average profit. How many years? For how many years we have to purchase? 3 years of purchase. For 3 years we will value the goodwill. Okay, and the profits for the last 4 years are here. The profits are given to us for the year ending 31st March 2016. It is 90,000. For the 31st March 2017, it is 1,60,000. For the 31st March 2018, these are 1,80,000. And for the year ended 31st March 2019, it is 2,20,000. Okay, these are the profits with us. And now we, first of all, we will apply the step first. Okay, for calculation of goodwill, first of all we will calculate the adjusted profit. First of all we will calculate the adjusted profit. Here the profits are given to us. Okay, profits are given to us. I am writing the profits here. For the year ended 31st March 2016, it is rupees 90,000. then 31st March 2017 it is 1,60,000. Then for 31st March 2018 it is 1,80,000. And for 31st March 2019, 2,20,000. Now we will make the adjustments. Now in the normal profit, we will make the adjustments so that we can calculate the adjusted profit. Okay. In this, we will add back the abnormal adjustments. Okay. If there is any abnormal profit, that is calculated and that is added. If it is added, then we will deduct, and if the abnormal losses are deducted, then we will add back. Okay. Now we will read out the additional information as per the question. What is the information given to us? During the year ended 2016, what is the year? 2016, an asset was sold at a gain of rupees 10,000. Ek asset ko kya hai? Here I am writing the working note that in 2016, an asset was sold at profit. And the profit is rupees 10,000. And we know that it is abnormal profit. We know that the profit gained from the sale of asset is abnormal profit because it is not related to recurring nature. Okay, it is not related to recurring nature. Kyun nahi hai? Because the sale of asset will not be done in a regular nature. Okay, assets ko kya hai? Regular nature ke andar sale nahi kiya jayega. That's why it is kept under the category of abnormal profit, and here we will deduct the profit which is realized from the sale of fixed assets. Okay, we will add we will deduct the profit in the bracket. I am showing the minus item. Okay, here we will deduct the profit which is realized from the sale of fixed assets. Next is, during 2017, a machine got destroyed in accident and rupees 30,000 was written off as loss in P&L account. We know that the machine is an asset. Okay, again there is a case of asset. Machine is an asset of the business, and this machine got destroyed. Iski kya hai? Destroy ho chuka hai. Due to that, there was a loss of rupees 30,000. Which was written off in P&L account. But we know that it is related to non-recurring nature. It is related to non-recurring nature. That's why it will not be included in this. Here, the loss was deducted from the P&L account. So, to calculate the adjusted profit, we will add back the loss which was deducted from the year 2017. ठीक है, हम क्या है, इस loss को वापस add back कर देंगे, because machine is an asset and it is related to no recurring nature. Next is, during the year 2018, firm's assets were not insured due to oversight. अब क्या था? 2018 के अंदर the assets were not insured. ये क्या है? Insurance is a regular nature expense, okay? And it was not insured. So now we will make the insurance expenses, and it is rupees 10,000. Okay? It is related to recurring nature. Ye kya hai? Regular nature ke andar hota hai. Because the insurance is made by the firm to protect the assets from the damages, okay? And in this case, the insurance was not done. Here you will not say that it is related to assets, then it will be kept under the category of non-recurring nature. No, it is related to assets. Ab insurance to assets nahi hoga. That's why it is related to recurring expenses. ठीक है, assets का क्या है? Regular nature के अंदर क्या है? Insurance करवाया जाता है. Okay, so it will be kept under the category insurance is a regular nature expenses, and it will be considered as regular expenses, and here we will make the insurance expenses deducted. Okay. Next, for the year ended 2019, there is no adjustment, so it will be flat. Okay. Now we will calculate the difference Okay, what is the difference? 90,000 minus adjusted profit will be 90,000 minus 10,000. 80,000, 160,000 plus 30,000. 190,000, 180,000 minus 10,000. 170,000, 220,000 minus nil. So, 0 has, then it will come to 220,000. Now we will make the total of profits. Okay, we will do the total of profit. That what is the total profits for the 4 years? Total profits will be ₹6,60,000 for the 4 years. Okay, this is the total profit which has come after the adjustment. We have made all the necessary adjustments in this profit. Now we will calculate the average profit. Okay, now we will calculate the average profit. Formula is total of profits, total profits divided by number of years. Okay, this is the formula for the average profit. What is total profit? ₹6,60,000, and the number of years are 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, number of years are 4. So we will divide the 6,60,000 divided by 4. It will come 1,65,000. This is the average profit. Okay, this is the average profit. This is related to step second. We have calculated the step second. Okay, in the step one, we have made the adjustments in the profit and we have calculated the adjusted profit. In the step second, we have calculated the average profit. In the step third, it is already given to us. I have told you that in 99% the step third will be given, and the step third is number of years purchased, and number of years purchased is given already. That is 3 number of year purchased. We have to evaluate the goodwill for the 3 years. Okay. And now here I am applying the step four. Okay. Step third is here, that is related to 3 number of years purchased. And the step in the step 4, we are doing the number of year purchased multiplied by average profit. Okay, average profit multiplied by number of years . Okay, I am writing here average profit. Keep in mind that it is ₹1,65,000. Okay, here I am applying step 4. Step 4 is number average profit multiplied by number of years purchased. Okay, average profit was ₹1,65,000 multiplied by 3. Okay, it is given to us that we have to evaluate the goodwill for the 3 years of purchase. Then we will multiply the, here we will calculate the goodwill. Okay, in the step 4, it will come the value of goodwill. We will multiply the average profit into number of years purchased, and we will multiply the 1,65,000 into 3, and it will come ₹4,95,000. This is the value of goodwill. ठीक है, ये वैल्यू है गुडविल की, विच इज परचेज गुडविल. कीप वन थिंग इन माइंड दैट एज पर अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड 26, अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड 26 सेज दैट ओनली द परचेज गुडविल विल बी वैल्यूड. ओके, देयर विल बी अ वैल्यूएशन ऑफ परचेज गुडविल ओनली सेल्फ जनरेटेड गुडविल. सेल्फ जनरेटेड गुडविल कैन नॉट बी कैलकुलेटेड, कैन नॉट बी वैल्यूड. ओके, सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन द गुडविल वॉज रिलेटेड टू परचेज गुडविल. Here the Simran purchased the business of Anita. ठीक है, यहाँ पे क्या था, in this question the Simran purchased the business of Anita, so it was related to purchase goodwill. Then only we have done the valuation of goodwill. Okay, and like this we have completed all the four steps, and we have done the valuation of goodwill. So students, this is the first method which we have completed. I have told you in the previous video the concept of this, that how to calculate the goodwill by step by step. Okay, I have explained all the steps in the previous video. If you haven't seen, please see that video. Then solve the numerical problems. Okay, and if you face any problem, you are free to ask. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.